Governor. This is actually our story conference, and today we will be introducing to you the Philippine Media, the cast, and the director of Black Sheep's upcoming co-production with Epic Media. This is Motel Acacia. So we want to introduce first the director and producer, Mr. Brad Liew.
Okay. Thank you all for coming. This is the first time that everyone is all together, I guess, publicly. And it's very exciting. We have already shot about 5 days of our 28-day shoot.
Thank you and welcome to Motel Acacia. I'm excited because this is, yes, my first international film with international cast.
Thank you. It's been great. Meeting a lot of actors from different countries. It's super exciting.
Well, it's a horror film. It's a love story. It's a father and son film. It's a film about brotherhood and friendship. But there's also a film about a young Filipino man, JC. He's brought over to this fictional, cruel, and cold, wintry country by his father. And they go on his journey into a motel that has a creature that eats men and impregnates women. Southeast Asian culture, we share a lot of mythology. We share a lot of creatures. Creatures in Malaysia would have its equivalent in the Philippines and in Indonesia and in Thailand. So, there's also the question that, if everyone shares the same mythology, like, could the creatures also have existed?
Who's going to do the post-production? Who's going to do the CGI?
So post-production will be done in Thailand with White Light Studios led by Lee Chattimitikul. Lee Chattimitikul was the editor of Shutter, colorist of Call Me By Your Name. But in terms of VFX, I would say there's only 1% of VFX in the film. 99% of the entire film will be live practical effects. So everything we create live in camera, the creatures are sculpted by hand. The effects are all live, the way people meet their demise would all be captured in camera with zero computer graphics. But this is, in my opinion, this is a true essence of a co-production. Many countries coming together, many people coming together from all around the world to try and tell a story together.
It's a learning experience. When we did the reading, normally you just read and then you say your lines. But here, we really, parang hinihimay, we kind of dissect the lines and the way they have a different take on certain dialogue. So that's good learning experience for us because it's coming from different cultures, so it's very cultural also.
I'm living the dream because it's like theater process for me, and I came from the theater before. So script analysis, table work, and getting to know all the characters and their own process, I'm learning a lot of things. And now we get deeper as a script, and it's amazing. It's like theater process. We have a theater actor here, and I'm with great actors here. Oh my God. Have you googled their names and their IMDb's? so far it's amazing. It's an amazing feeling that I'm working with a lot of great actors and knowing their own process and their capabilities, seeing that in front of me.
I think this is a really, really special story to be told because I think Bradley has some kind of image on how it could be in the future with now immigration these days. And it's such, we need to change. We are now in a with the B2 eras and about racist things. There are things happening and we should continue telling these stories because I think in the Western world, the white people, it's time to shut their mouths, welcoming everybody from abroad and apologize.
This is the first one where we have worked on something together, but this is the first one where you actually play a couple. And
what's that like?
It's very true to life. Funnily enough.
Yeah, this is just such a smart and imaginative and truthful film, like Jan was saying, and I feel really privileged to be part of this cast and part of Brad's film. So thank you for having me.
I find the urgency, I find the relevance, and also a lot of things that could, very urgent things that we need to say right now in the world, in our society. So I promise you guys, it will be a very interesting film to watch.
When I read the script, of course, we spoke about the social political, but I think it's also a revenge movie by nature. Mm-hmm. It's like, you know, how nature gets back at us with, you know, pillaging the forest and everything. So it's a revenge, how Mother Nature works and try to reclaim their rights.
So we all have responsibility as an actor, as an artist, and as a human being, to send a message out and let people realize that it's time to take care of our world, you know, our forest, our animal, and each other, the most important thing. Thank you.
I think we are all still recovering from the scars of colonization and what the colonists did to us and how they divided us and how they divided people, not just within regions, but also within countries and within tribes, within cultures. And the scars are still seen today and how people use that to manipulate each other. I think if everyone, not just in the Philippines, but especially in the Philippines, if we can see that how these divisive tactics are still being used against us by people in power, I think, you know, we really still have a chance to save our humanity in a way.
Thank you.